Jay!
Harley, don't jump! Don't worry, I'll save you. I'm Batman. Okay, I'll just... Oh, jeez, that really hurt. All right, I got you, Harley. I got... Oh, jeez, I missed. Oh, my back.
Batman Vengeance, PC version released in 2002. This is a third-person action platformer based around the Batman animated series. So first off, the lighting in this game is rather dark, so I'm gonna brighten up the screen a little so you can see it better. As you can see, the graphics aren't that great in this game, but they're close enough to the animated series to give you a visually pleasing experience. The game also features some of the original voice actors of the animated series.
It's the Joker, and maybe more. Something about this woman doesn't add up.
Now, I don't want to talk about the plot too much in this one. It's kind of a mystery, and it's always fun and interesting to see how it unfolds as you play it, so I'm just going to kind of leave that out. So, I guess you can call this a decent Batman simulator, I guess. You can do a lot of things you would expect to do with Batman, like it's complete with gliding, sneaking in the shadows, using your cape to block bullets, and you get various Batman gadgets to use, such as the Batarangs and the Bat Grapple. When using most gadgets, it switched to this first-person shooter type mode, and it seems cool, but this was probably unnecessary. They should have did a over-the-shoulder type view. The switching back and forth kind of broke the flow of the game up. And I found myself fumbling a bit with the buttons because of the slight differences between the two modes' control inputs. Minor enemies in the game are pretty much all the same. They're just reskins of each other, pretty much. Some of them carry guns, which you can disarm with your batarangs or punching them. And when getting into combat, you enter this locked mode where you're kind of in this fisticuffs fight. Batman does have some fairly simplistic punch and kick combos, and can do some power-up attacks by holding the attack buttons, but these fights are pretty much just button mashers and unfortunately are not much of a highlight of this game. The levels themselves, though, are pretty enjoyable. Some stages have elements to them that are totally unique to that stage. There's some challenging platforming, and although the game is fairly linear, you will have to do a bit of exploring in the areas to find a key, for example, to progress to the next level. Unfortunately, there is going to be some trial and error on these stages, and usually there's only one checkpoint on each level, so this becomes irritating, losing progress and restarting just because you don't know what you're supposed to do. Some stages will have some puzzle solving, and there are some stages where you'll be flying the Batwing or driving the Batmobile. And these extra vehicle stages certainly sound good, but you know what, they're pretty poor and really not that fun. It's nice to see they try to stick some variety into this, but they just really aren't good games at all. The boss battles in the game are pretty cool. Well, the ones with the iconic characters anyway. The Joker, Poison Ivy, Mr. Freeze. These are pretty simple pattern-based battles, but the ideas presented in them are fun, like the Joker on a wrecking ball. So I did find the boss battles, even though there's not very many, the most entertaining part of this game. Now, the worst offender in this game, I would say, has to be the camera. You can't rotate it, but the camera takes these cinematic angles now and again. So to get the camera behind you again, you have to enter first-person mode to reset the camera back. And this is really annoying how often you have to do this. It's not good either that you have to switch into first-person mode too to look around. Doing this can leave you vulnerable to a melee attack. Or if the camera angles off a bit, you might mess up an important jump. So it's completely unfair to punish a player because of a poor implementation of a camera. So overall, Batman Vengeance is, well, a mixed bag. The story's not great, but it's alright. The combat's poor, but the platforming's pretty good. Its attempt at variety really falls short in the fun category, but the boss battles are cool. And there are some enjoyable game mechanics here, but it was mixed with some bad design choices for the controller and the first-person mode. Now, this is not a horrible game, but the controls and the camera issues really disrupted the play experience for me. Now, this might be better on the console versions for this game, but for the PC version, it was a really notable annoyance. And because of that, I personally can't recommend this game. I would say give it a pass. But if you do want to try it, just keep in mind you might find its flaws outweigh its good points. So there you have it, Batman Vengeance. Thanks for watching.